Hello, ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to the old stream farm, where today it's time to do some silage. We have a new piece of equipment. A good friend of mine, Pedro, nice Spanish chap he is, has given us for free, pretty much, well, at a huge discount, a Pottinger Mex 6. I think. New Pottinger Forager. So we're using that instead of the Mengele, which I sold to fund the purchase of said Pottinger. And, yeah, we're doing silage in what I would consider to be kind of a legit way. This is the way that I've always really seen it done. I don't see too many big or big X's or Jaguars or anything around like that around here, so even the short period of time that I've been here, it's always been it's always trailed forage harvesters. He is driving the tractor for us, by the way. However, he doesn't like bringing it back to the yard, so we have to do this for him. And once again, I want to apologize for any framing issues you might see in the game today. I'm still trying to figure out what's causing them. Legitimately have no idea. But we do have the... I do have a field already done. It's the pasture for the sheep. I don't have any sheep at the moment, so there's no point in... Sorry, the pasture for the cows, I believe. Don't have any of them at the moment, so I don't see the point of keeping their pasture empty. I am making a hint. I am not good at reversing today. I am just so bad at reversing today. Let's see if I can get this right. There we go. So this trailer can be a bit finicky at times. It's being a bit finicky. Sometimes it decides it doesn't want to let the grass out, so I gotta kind of shake it a bit. The even just from the one field that I've done, I've noticed that it can be a bit of a pain to get this trailer unloaded. Come on. Go. It's unloaded. Let's lower it down. Get back over to the field. Pedro will be taking over at some point in the field. It's just a case of wonderful. Getting up to the TS and we should be good. You can see we are doing a really good job. Wow. I'm impressed with my own amazing abilities. So Pedro can take over from here. And hopefully not derp about too much. Wonderful. This is back to harvesting we go. We are kind of at a slow speed, 10 kilometers an hour, but really we wouldn't want to be going much faster than this anyway. We are cutting quite a lot of grass into quite a lot of silage. Or we're barely even cutting, we're just really picking it up and depositing it again into the trailer, so not doing too much chopping to it. Are we picking it all up? We are picking it all up. Magnificent. And this is pretty much going to be me for the rest of the day, is on the forager, cutting the grass into chaff, and getting it up off the ground. Because that is, of course, priority number one. Does look quite spectacular though with these two vehicles. Side by side, two kind of different eras in farming almost. You got the boxy era and the slightly less boxy but still quite boxy era. From the 90s. That'll have to do. And what I'm gonna do is, okay. Again, we'll just line up on this swath and completely ruin it because I forgot I had the harvester still turned on. But we do have to bring this tractor back down now. Empty her out. And we will have quite a lot of silage at the end. I mean, this is the third trailer now already. This is, what, 45 odd thousand litres in the clamp straight away. So no shortages. None at all. It's just a case of actually reversing this thing correctly, which I would now appear to be doing for the most part. We will get some, just reverse this right back to the back and just roll it forward slowly, I think. When I said slowly, I meant slowly, not 10 kilometers an hour. There we go. Okay, let's just try and get it all out here. Roughly. Come on. You know you want to. And out of character real quick. Yeah, this is just, side it doesn't seem to want to behave for me at all lately. This is what I've had to be doing. And while it doesn't look too realistic, it works, and that's kind of the main thing. That's the trailer empty once again. What I'm going to do real quick is I'm going to turn this off, let Pedro have a cup of tea or something, and we'll get into this mess. Come on, come on. You'll start, you'll start, you'll start. Lovely. We'll get into this machine. And push the silage. I need to make sure I'm actually pushing it. Push it up to the end of the clamp here. There we go. Not gonna worry too much about compacting it just yet. Although I probably should. Probably should worry about compacting it actually, but it's a problem for another day. Well, later today, in fact. Let's just get a bit of a ramp going here, I think. Might be a good idea. So that I can run the trailer up on it at the very least. There we go. I think I've made the capacity of this thing far too big. Because I did edit this thing a while back, just to try and give it better leveling capacity, and it's actually worked against me, because now it's able to pick up all of the silage ever, all the chaff ever. Ironically, it does seem to be working better now, though. How compacted are we? 31%. With 44,000 liters of silage in the clamp. Just raise this up so that we can get a good ramp going up to the back. If it wants to work, please let it work. No, it's just going to keep picking... well, I guess if it keeps picking up and dropping the silage, that's actually going to work in my favor. Let's possibly push some through. No. So what I'm doing is I'm just making this into a ramp so that I can, in theory, run the trailer up it. And actually, do you know what, Leah? Let's move back onto the actual cutting, because I can. What I can do with the capacity it has is actually just shove it straight in. So let's get back to the field. I know I'm taking a slightly different route, but that's fine. It doesn't matter if I take the same route up and down. Don't have a very long journey to the forager. And you can see our crops aren't quite growing yet. But they will be growing soon. Ignore the fact that I got stuck in the trailer. Ever so briefly. Do I think I could pull that in closer? Yes. Oh ho ho, why is this not working now? Am I a meter too far away? Is it just not gonna work on this side? Has it gotta be straight it's gotta be straight over the... That's different. That is very different. But as you can see, we are loading the grass in relatively nicely. Not having too many issues. I have heard word from both the council and the local homeowners association. The residential council from over there, field, I think it's number 10. They have a push mower. No, not going to work for me. They've got a little Honda push mower. That ain't going to work. I have heard word of a Profi Hopper, an Amazon Profi Hopper, on the market at the moment. That may be worth getting. Because if nothing else, I can throw it into the silage pits and make silage out of the grass that I mow. But a push mower just ain't gonna cut it. And that is the trailer full again. So let's get down to the pit once again. Once again. We're making good progress through this field, 10 kilometers an hour. It is gonna take a little while for me to get all the silage in. But what I can do is I can be smart about it. And I can, with the help of that bulldozer, basically plonk the silage down there, like this, roughly speaking. Once there's some form of ledge that I can use. Come on. You don't want to unload any more there. Here we go. So now we will most definitely need to use the bulldozer. Let's just leave that running. Because this shouldn't take too long to get the bulldozer over this. It should, roughly speaking, be about 15,000 litres, which is what this thing can push. In hindsight, maybe a bit much. So I might bump it down again. But let's get this thing around the grass somehow. I'm gonna have to run over it a bit. Crushy, crushy, crushy grass. There we go. Lay down. And away we go, shoving the grass into the pit. In a very haphazard manner that actually is working in my favor right now. That actually has worked entirely in my favor. Because now I've got a little path I can follow out. Hooray! In we go once more. Let's not picking it all up. This should, in theory, but it's not going to. I need to lift it ever so slightly just to get that extra little bit of punch into it. There we go. It's got to be lifted ever so slightly more. There may be a bit of grass permanently at the exit of the silage pit. But it is going to be a case of get the grass to here, push it in, and then hope for the best. Now, if all else fails, I could always try using the stire on the trailer. Because in theory, it can carry what the trailer has. Hey, got rid of the bit of grass that was there. Awesome. And our compaction isn't going too well, though. This bulldozer isn't very heavy. How much money do we have? 9,700. We can get rid of... I know Sergei won't be happy, but I'll get him something bigger. 32 and 8. And I believe there is a bigger bulldozer available for... if I can find it. 15,995. Well, let's get this thing backed up away from the pit. Get our two new pieces of equipment. Because by selling the dozer, I don't know why this is in such demand that it commands a £33,000 price tag, but it does. But by doing that, we can now buy what I like to call Big Daddy Dozer, which Sergei unfortunately won't be able to use to work, but that might work in my favor. As well as an Amazon Profi Hopper, which I don't have loaded into the game. Fantastic, Dave, you genius. I will have a Profi Hopper next time. We'll get that dozer delivered real quick. Shop does offer delivery occasionally, and they tend to when they deliver offload it over here. There she is. Or P, I guess I'm calling it Big Daddy Dozer. This thing is an absolute beast. I'm gonna take a minute to warm up, and we are away. Big engine, big blade. Big difference. Because this thing is going to be a silage pushing monster. And a little demonstration is going to be by collecting all this grass up, no problem at all. Lifting the blade ever so slightly and shoving. Now let's lift the blade up a lot and push all the silage down to the back. Okay. seems to have missed ever so slightly. There we go. This should, in theory, collect it. But there's grass still in the thingy, which means it won't collect it for some reason. Is it not going to pick up the shaft because I got grass in? Oh, that's magnificent. Oh no, this may be a bad idea. I may need two dozers. Oh no, it's dropped the grass. That's actually going to work in my favor, being there. It's now registering a zero grass, so this should, if I lower it right there, yep, pick up most, if not all, of the chaff. Oh, with room to spare. With room to spare. And deposit it in a nice big lump like that. Because now what I can do is I can really compact. So we're at 43% compacted. 44. If I spin this around, I might even be able to get better compaction going on. One time that you want something that'll just compact the whatever it touches is when you're compacting silage. Let's get this to 100% compacted and then move on to doing some more harvesting. Although I don't think you might have to leave before then. The believe it or not, the microphone battery is now running low. I need to start investing in better batteries, I think. But yeah. We got Big Daddy Dozer on the farm now. Sergey will be pleased to see an even bigger bulldozer than he managed to find. And we will be cutting silage for the rest of the day, most likely. But that's something I can do, at least mostly, off camera. I will leave you now by saying, I've been Rainbow Dave, you've been watching Farming Simulator 17 on Old Streams, the Old Streams Farm, Old Streams V2, whatever you want to call it, Streamy Oldington. Hope you enjoyed the video. If you did, hit that like button down below and hit the subscribe button as well. And yeah, we'll get back to this tomorrow, hopefully with some more mowing, but in a different way. Until then, stay safe, and goodbye.